About 40,000 years ago today, one of our distant ancestors, the Neanderthals, discovers that smacking sticks together can actually produce rhythmic music. With the sky clear and possibly favorable on our side, we start our journey to search for the Hyrax Hill National Museum. This is a journey into the wilderness as we try to look for clues to answer our question, how did nature inspire the origin of music? Remember that in this channel we go an extra mile to bring you amazing facts about music in a way that you have never heard before, and in most cases you will be shocked if not surprised.
A strange art, the most poetic and precise of them all. Vague as a dream and precise as algebra, music is the wine that fills the cup of silence. Welcome once again to the Sivoken Guitar Channel, a channel where we give you amazing facts about music in a way that will leave your mouth wide open. And today, we take you into the world as we try to find clues on how nature inspired the origin of music. Great, as I have said in many of my videos from my channel, is that music played a major role in the lives of our distant ancestors. But the question is, what inspired the origin or the invention of music? And the answer to that is very simple. As you can see, we have the hill there, which we call the Hyrax Hill in Nakuru, Kenya. And you can see the diversity of the crabs and the vegetation there. And as they say that in nature, there is peace. If you can listen in the background, there is peace and silence. But it is said that the sound that the animals produce, the howling of the wind, may have provided clues to our distant ancestors on how to create rhythm and come up with basic music. And today we will take you on a tour within the Hyrax Hill National Museum to try and find out if we can see these clues that will help us to know the ancestors who lived here, what type of musical instruments that they used. Today, we are at the Hyrax Hill National Museum, and as you can see, these stones are arranged with some kind of a pattern. This was not by accident. Remember, this museum dates between 5,000 to 200 years ago. Now, conventional wisdom has it that music is a fairly recent or modern human invention, and one that, while fun and rewarding, is more of a luxury rather than a basic necessity of life. Now, we are told that although the first hand axes and spears date between 1.7 million years ago and 500,000 years ago respectively, the ancient or the oldest musical instrument known dates only about 40,000 years ago. Now, there is one musical instrument that was discovered in Slovenia, and it is thought to have belonged to our distant ancestors, Neanderthals. Although this find has a lot of controversy, because it is a bone flute, and some researchers argue that the finger holes in quotes of this bone flute are nothing more than puncture wounds that a carnivore left when it chewed the bone. These are some of the challenges that we have in our search to find the origin of music. But as we shall see later, more evidence suggests that indeed it is from the animals the sounds they made, and the nature, the howling of the wind and everything, that our distant ancestors discovered there is music. And what do you think? Do you think language evolved before music, or music before language? As usual, you can leave your comments below.
Great. Unfortunately, we were denied permission to film in the gallery of the museum, but still we will take you on a stepwise journey through all that is in the museum, and you will be able to learn a lot, from the cobra, as you can see there, to the waterbuck. Remember, this is an animal whose horn was actually used to produce some musical instruments. We have the flamingo, which is a favorite bird in this community, and is but in many ways the theme that nature, or Mother Nature, has always been our inspiration is still depicted here, because here we see different aspects of their lifestyle, from the things that they use to prepare their food to decorations, as you can see in the screen, the ornaments that were worn to increase the beauty of these people, to spears and shields during battle. As you can see in the background, we have musical instrument. This is a symbol that indeed music had many purposes in the lives of these people. And in this gallery, we have horn instruments and flutes with about three holes, and then we have shakers. And if you don't know the classification of these musical instruments, watch my video on the African musical instruments. Find a link at the end of this video. Indeed, this place is breathtaking, and if you have a chance, you can visit so that you enjoy, learn, and have fun with your friends.
A literal prehistoric reading tells us that there was a time when there was a momentous change in the continent of Europe. This was the time when our distant ancestors, the Neanderthals, were replaced by a human species, our very own, the Homo sapiens. The Homo sapiens, we are told, were clever in our way than the former Neanderthals. These range from their musical instruments and even their powerful weapons. But you dig deeper, the story becomes even more interesting. We are told that recent evidence suggests that chimpanzees can actually recognize different sound patterns in a way similar to which humans can actually distinguish slight differences between melodies. Now, when this Homo sapiens came around, we are told that there is one musical instrument that researchers can speak with confidence that indeed they use to sing their songs, and this musical instrument is the human voice. We are told that the human voice is the oldest musical instrument, and they copied the languages, the sounds made by animals, and we are actually told that it is possible that music may have originated earlier than language. The human voice may have achieved a full vocal range around 530,000 years ago, and the Neanderthals started singing about 40,000 years ago. So indeed, music existed in our distant ancestors. But as we said, nature has always been our biggest inspiration in everything. And right now, you can feel that indeed, there is a lot of peace, but there is some sound, background sound, either trees moving or the howling of the sound, or once in a while, the sound from an animal, where we are told that our ancestors may have actually discovered music from the sound patterns, especially from the bird. And when they discover that the bird can actually make these sounds, and they become in a pattern, they discover music. Because remember, the definition of music in its simplest form is sound organized in time. And in this Iraq Hill National Museum, as we have seen, there is a lot of evidence that the people indeed incorporated music in their lives. Because remember, music serves a lot of functions in the society. One, being for worship. Second, it brings people together. Third, it is for entertainment. And many, including rituals like burials and weddings, indeed music is part of us as humans.
This is one of the sites that was excavated by Dr. Mary Leakey and her husband that led to the discovery of many remains, some of which we have already seen at the gallery. Now from here we want to head up the hill to the peak, find some of the places where those who used to blow horns during times of war will stand and blow horns. Remember, the highest peak meant that the sound will disseminate downwards in all directions and reach all communities to warn them of imminent danger. Indeed, nature has always proved to be our inspiration as humans.
great. Now we are almost at the peak of the hierarchy here. And remember, this place is named after the small animal that we saw in the museum, the hierarchy. Now we are told that abilities which underlie our musical traits can actually be explained from the tactics that we use. Because we are told the tactics we use to process information or music right now may have been used for other purposes in our distant ancestors. And now this is almost the peak. In a few moments, we will go to the peak of the hierarchy where we will be able to see it more like a vintage point, to see the surrounding area of Nakuru Town and the Lake Nakuru National Park. Enjoy yourself. Great. As you can see from the screen, indeed now we are at the peak of the hierarchy hill. And indeed, as you can see, the scenes down there, they are surprising and but at the same time interesting. Now here we can relay that indeed during those days this is where the person who used to announce wars and emerging threats will stand with a horn and blow it, because now this being the highest point, the sound will distribute all over so that all the communities down there will actually get the message. And that was one purpose of music, to announce imminent danger or war. Indeed, you can agree that this scene is interesting, and this is a place worth visiting, the Hierarchy Hill National Museum in Nakuru, Kenya. Great, now we are almost coming to the end of our video, and we are going to climax our journey into the world, find clues of how music originated by playing a song on our guitar and singing to you in a few moments. Enjoy yourself.
Ah.
Very well. Now we have come to the end of our video on how nature inspired the original music. Now, as we head back home, most of our answers have been answered. That indeed, Mother Nature has always been our inspiration. Until next time, stay safe and let us meet in the next video.